Welcome back to Rest Let's Play. Frontier. When last we left, we had entered the haunted house Odum. And now we are taking out 100 minions in it. Already up to 9, and in a few minutes that'll be 11. And the bat's back with us. Well, clearly we just aren't very bright. However, we are strong. Ow. Froggy's gonna need some healing. And now we're up to 16. Heal up for a moment. Because we're about to fight one of the many bosses of this area. They are mini bosses only in that they are not as strong compared what we'll actually be going up against at the end of it. But trust me on this, they are very much full-fledged, will kick your butt. Not weak at all. I really don't like that jump stabity attack. I don't know why, it doesn't do much damage, but it just... Meat slush. I mean, slash. Now there's a reason I went against this guy first, and that is because I'll be able to get his sword. Not terribly effective. That, however, is quite strong. Yay, counter. Ah, that's right. Just beat on him. a counter. And now he gets out his sword. I don't think that was quite as effective as I would have liked. Yeah, I think we're gonna stick with just straight fighting. Ow. Alright, everybody heal. That was close. And I hate to say that Luca is reduced to the healer, it's just that she's not as effective a fighter in this instance, and her talents are put to better use. Remember, it's not about thinking that you're wasting your party's talents as much as it is about making sure you're keeping your party alive. And like I said, slash is a nasty, nasty fight. And if you're not careful, he can mop the floor with you. Thankfully, we got him. And we got his sword. Putting on right now. Also, speed boost. In addition to, it's not a huge upgrade over the Flint Edge, but that speed will pay dividends. Alright, so we're going to heal up here, and we are going to save. And we'll be back with you soon. Until then, good gaming.